Today, we're going to be making a madder lake pigment. Please look forward to it.
These pigments are made from roots from the madder plant, which is a plant that for thousands of years has been used to make pigments and dyes. These particular madder root fragments are from Turkey, and we begin by putting 10 grams of the coarsely ground root in a netting bag so that we can soak it overnight in a beaker with water. What begins as crude pieces from this root end up becoming an absolutely brilliant red dye, the likes of which has even been used in King Tut's tomb for its beautiful red color. These are the beakers after being soaked overnight. In this case, we used 300 milliliters of water in a 500 milliliter beaker. Our solutions are then heated up to 70 degrees Celsius so that we can extract the dyes. Be careful not to get distracted by the Scottish weather, because these Bunsen burners can get quite hot.
Once we hit 70 degrees Celsius, it's time to move on to the next step.
We will then need to filter the hot solution, so we build an apparatus here so that it can go through a filter into a new beaker. After it's filtered, we will carefully add 5 grams of potash alum to the warm solution and then reheat it to 70 to 80 degrees Celsius. The temperatures are very important to these chemical processes. Think of it sort of like baking. If you get even the smallest of measurements or temperatures wrong in your oven, it can have dire consequences, and you might turn out with something you don't want. While this reheats, we add 1.88 grams of potassium carbonate to 50 milliliters of water in another 500 milliliter beaker. This will eventually be added to our dye solution. Once the dye stuff solution is at the proper temperature, then it's slowly added to the alkaline solution and then slowly, constantly stirred with a glass rod. As this happens, one should be checking the pH, and it should be no less than 6 on the scale. You may notice some pink froth forming. This is normal. Once your pH is at the proper amount and your stirring is complete, you leave the dye stuff solution to settle overnight. And when you return, you probably notice a separation that had happened in the beaker. The solution is taken and then it is once again filtered into a new beaker. This time, it moves even slower. And once the first filtration is complete, then it's filtered again with demineralized water until it's clear and no further color comes off. Afterwards, the filtration papers with the caught pigment are laid out to dry, and after a few days, it'll look like this. Carefully, these chunks of pigment are added to a mortar and pestle and ground slowly and efficiently until they reach a proper pigment. The finely ground pigment is added into a vial for future use. For it to be used as the pigment, you'd simply need to add it to a binder, like oil or egg. And that's the simple process to making this beautiful color of madder lake pigment.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Please enjoy your pigments.